Hi there and welcome to this video. In this video, you're going to see how to install Nextcloud on your VPS using HestiaCP. HestiaCP is a free open source control panel that has a built-in script installer / app installer. And that is what we are going to use to install Nextcloud, and it's going to make your work really easy installing Nextcloud or any other script such as WordPress and so on. First, you will need a server. If you don't have a server, please feel free to support my efforts. I'm going to use Vultr for this demonstration, and I will add my Vultr link in the description, and the link will come with $100 credit. You can use that to test Vultr. If you want to use DigitalOcean, I'm also going to add my link in the description. That will give you $200 credit, and I will also add my Contabo and Hetzner link and OVH. If you want to use any VPS to run Nextcloud, please consider supporting me. I will put my links in the description. Thanks in advance. I did create a video for how to get your server running on Vultr, how to log in using SSH key, using an SSH key and so on. So I will put the link for that video as well if you want to deploy your Vultr server. So go ahead and log into your server. I'm already logged into mine, and I can just check if I have any updates, apt-update. So you can see I'm using the root user, but if you're not using root, you're going to have to use sudo. Let me upgrade the one package. Enter Control L to clear the screen, and then I'm going to go to HestiaCP, and I need to generate an installation script. So I'm not going to use Apache. I'm going to use Nginx and PHP FPM, as is recommended for anyone that is using a small server. If you have a small server, 4GB and below, just use Nginx and a PHP FPM instead of using Apache. So we're going to generate our script. So for the port, I want to use port 2083 because that port is acceptable via the Cloudflare network. And then host name, I've already added my domain here to Cloudflare, and I'm going to use pan.cloudubuntu.com as my host name. So make sure you add the A record for the domain that you want to use as a host name, and also for the domain where you want to install Nextcloud. And for me, I'm going to install it on this subdomain. So I've already added an A record for that. If you haven't, make sure you do that before you start the installation. That way the propagation can be done by the time you're done installing HestiaCP. I'm going to come back here, and I'm going to use my custom hostname as pan dot that, and then email, I can just use sample3@gmail.com, and then for password, I can just copy, and I'm going to use that as my admin password for HestiaCP. And as I said, I'm not going to use Apache, so I'm going to disable Apache. PHP, I'm going to install multiple PHP versions. This is for FTP server. Bind is for DNS. MariaDB, of course, database. We need that for Nextcloud. Exim is for sending mail. And this one as well are for security, mail, firewall, fail to ban, IP tables, spam assassin, all this. Just leave those installed. And then we want to force the installation. Now we can install HestiaCP. So I will copy that into your VPS where you're logged in. I want to do this inside of TMP, inside of the temp directory, so that it doesn't clog my root home folder. So I'm going to paste that in there. The installation script is downloaded. Now the parameters for installing HestiaCP, let's add this here, Control Shift V. To paste on my terminal. So just paste the way your terminal allows you to paste. If you're not the root user, you'll need to add sudo on this. So I'm going to press enter. You have to accept explicitly by typing in capital Y, enter, and that's going to install Nginx, PHP, Bind, Exim, Dovecot, and MariaDB, all this. This will take some time, so I'm just going to give it some time, and then we'll come back once the installation is complete. Then log into HestiaCP and see how we can proceed with the installation. While HestiaCP is installing, I would like to reiterate that you need to add your DNS records for the domain or the subdomain where you'll be installing Nextcloud. So in my case, I'm going to install it here. So I've added an A record with the IP address of my server. You can also add www.next with a CNAME to next.your domain. This is going to be my host name, and you're going to see that the benefit of having this here is that I can access my panel using the subdomain instead of using my IP. Let's just wait for the installation to complete, and then we're going to access the panel. HestiaCP is now installed and we can access it. So you can see, this is what a control panel does for you. So all these things have been installed for me. These are things that if I want using a control panel, I would have to do manually by myself. So this is why a control panel is efficient and makes your work way, way easier. So let me copy this. Copy. And I will put them here. Control V. So I can access my domain, my Hestia panel, using this. So here as well, I was told press any key to continue. So I can press any key to continue, and that's going to restart the server. So if I come to an incognito window, I can go to my panel. Hopefully the server is started. So the server is still starting. Control L to clear the screen. The server is not yet running. Just give it time to restart. There we go. We can now access our control panel. Now you can see I can access it using this because Cloudflare already has an SSL, and this is also using a self-generated SSL. So if you want it to work like that, you'd have to come to Cloudflare under SSL and make sure at least you're using full protection. You can see with full SSL, you can use a self-signed certificate. If you want to use strict mode, you'd have to create a certificate using Let's Encrypt at least. So let's come back and log into HestiaCP. I will go into admin, username as admin, and then the password is what I set, which was that. Copy that, put it there, enter. There we go. You're now in HestiaCP. And the first thing I want to do, since I'm going to be installing Nextcloud, is I'm going to change some of the PHP settings. You can see you have many PHP versions here. If you feel that these are too many PHP versions, just click here on configure, and then under web server, you can uninstall various PHP versions. If you feel you don't need it, you can uninstall them. Just remember that this is going to take some time. So I'm just going to go back because I know that usually takes some time. So once you do that, just click on save. Click on save and it will uninstall those PHP versions. Let me click here on user and I will click back on configuration settings. And I want to, this is a PHP version I'm going to use with Nextcloud. So I'm just going to click on that. But usually with HestiaCP, if you change anything here, it's going to change it for the other PHP versions. For that, let's just do 100. 100. Memory limit, let's do 512. I think that's the recommended version. That's the recommended option. And then post max size, I'm just going to leave it at the default. Then I'm going to save. And even before you go here, okay, we're going to see if we experience that error. If we experience that error, we're going to come back here and Control F inside here, Control F. We need to find PC. Yeah, so PC NTL, and then we're going to disable this while installing. If we experience that PC NTL error, if we don't, we're just going to forget about this. So let's go back, and I've changed some settings for PHP. So let me just restart it. Restart PHP. And now let's see what next we need to do. Okay, you can see we only have one user, admin. Usually when you get HestiaCP, the first thing you need to do is create a new user. And that is the user you're going to use with your domains, your websites, email, and so on. So I'm just going to click here, add user. let's just call it user 99, and we can call it user, give the name user 99 to this user, email address, we can do user 99 at Gmail. Of course, this is a sample, and I will give it a password. I don't even need to copy the to save the password because I can just log in via the admin user. So anything else I need to do for this user? I don't think so. I'm just going to leave the role as a normal user. You can make them an admin as well, but I'm going to leave it as normal user. And then I'm going to save the details to create this user. So if you go back to users, you'll see that we have two users. I'm just going to click on this user to log in as that user. And then we're going to add our domain where we are going to install Nextcloud. So I'm going to come here and into DNS, under DNS settings for that domain. I want to copy the domain name there because I don't want to type. I'm just going to copy, and I will come back here, add a web domain, paste. I can add in DNS support. So since I'm using Cloudflare, this is just going to generate various DNS records, and you can copy those records from here into Cloudflare, especially for email. I'm just going to click on save. You can also enable mail support if you're going to use mail with this domain. In my case, I'm just going to click on save. And that has created the domain, but let's go and generate an SSL certificate for that domain. So I'm going to click there, and it's going to bring the settings for that domain. You can enable statistics for this. You can use OSTATS. I will not enable web statistics for the domain. And then I'm going to enable SSL. I will use Let's Encrypt. I will enable automatic HTTPS redirection. And I can also enable strict mode for HTTPS. Under advanced options, let's see what we have here. We can change the web template. Now for Nginx and Nextcloud, you can use OnCloud, but I do believe this is going to get changed automatically when you click to install Nextcloud. You can enable fast CGI, but I'm not going to do that. And then backend template for this, I'm going to use PHP 8.2. All these other options as well, you can turn them on and change the document root where your files will be. If you don't, it's going to go to the default location, and we'll see where that is later. You can add additional FTP accounts. You can create FTP accounts so that you can access this domain. When you do so and you don't add the DNS records, make sure you're using the IP as your host name. With that, I'm going to click on save first to generate SSL. Make sure that before you click on save, your DNS records have been added and they're working properly, because if they're not, you're going to get a 400 error, and that will mean that you'll need to look at your DNS records. All right, this is a good sign. Everything has saved successfully. So we can click on web and we can go to the domain just to confirm that it is working, and we can see it is working. We are working on it. SSL is working. That's good. Now let's come back to the domain and click on it. And here, this is where you can install various scripts. So I'm just going to click there on quick install app. And you can see here, you can install different applications, WordPress, Laravel, and so on. I'm going to click on setup for Nextcloud to install Nextcloud. So here, I'm just going to create a user for Nextcloud, and I'm just going to use the same user, user 99. And then I'm going to generate a password, copy the password and save it here. User 99, and that's the password. So the rest, I will leave them as they are. They will get generated automatically. And let me save. If I experience any error, we are going to work on it until eventually we have Nextcloud installed. So I'm going to click there on save. All right, luckily I didn't experience any problem. And if you follow along with me step by step, the way I've done everything, probably you're not going to experience any problem. But if you do, you first of all, just go into your file manager and then delete everything that has already been done there. There will be files that will have already been added if you started the installation. So if you go into this domain, then you go into public HTML. Just click there and delete everything inside of public HTML. So now, if we refresh the page, you're going to see the Nextcloud login page. And I can copy the password from there. Why is this happening like this? Okay, just refresh. Now the user, I chose the user 99. And the password, paste, login. There you go. Nextcloud is installed. You can add Nextcloud on all your devices by installing the various apps, Google Play, App Store. We have achieved the goal of the video, and that was to install Nextcloud via HestiaCP. If you experience any errors at any point, first make sure that you have changed the PHP version to PHP 8.2, and then log out of this user, go into the admin user and change the PHP settings like I showed you. If the installation was interrupted, go into the file manager and delete everything inside of public HTML. Once you have made the changes, you can then try to reinstall Nextcloud. So that's it for this video. All right, so if you have any questions, let me know in the comments. I will try my best to reply in time. Sometimes I don't see the comments, so just try and comment again. Don't comment under somebody else's comment. So just start your own thread of comment if you have a question. So that's it for this video. If you're going to use any VPS for this and you're going to use one, just please consider supporting me. It takes a lot of time creating the videos, editing them, and your support is paramount to motivation. It's paramount to my motivation. Thank you for watching the video. I will see you next time.